world. I am going to briefly give a talk about and give a glimpse about one such natural wonder. Myself, Gopi G.V. I am a faculty and a scientist with Wildlife Institute of India, and I am going to be talking about water birds. Water birds are basically birds that are ecologically dependent on wetlands, and water birds are the greatest ambassadors of these wetlands. India, as a country, is bestowed with wide variety of wetlands. As you all know, India has got 10 biogeographic zones ranging from the Trans-Himalayas to the islands, and then in the east, the northeastern biogeographic zone, and to the west, the arid zones. These biogeographic zones and about 26 odd biogeographic provinces has a wide variety of wetland types like the glacial lakes, the floodplains, rivers, streams, marshes, oxbow lakes, lagoons, estuaries, mangroves, intertidal mudflats, the coastal beaches, and so on. And also, if you look at the classification, there are wetlands like natural wetlands to artificial wetlands, inland wetlands to coastal wetlands, small to large wetlands to very large wetlands. And all these different kinds of wetland types, the mosaic habitat types, gives rise to, you know, the harbor water birds as diverse as the wetland types themselves. Globally, there are about 870 water bird species distributed, of which about 243 species of water birds are distributed in India. And about 104 of these 243 species are winter migratory. These 243 species do not include about 34 species of vagrant water birds, which occasionally comes into India, and also it does not include some of the seabirds. So the World Conservation Union has classified about 44 of these 243 birds as threatened birds. Threatened in the sense, they have placed some of the birds in critically endangered category to endangered category to vulnerable and near threatened. There are about 5 species of water birds which are placed in critically endangered category, 4 in endangered category, 15 in vulnerable category, and 20 in near threatened category. I'll just give you some species names, and they all fall under these categories. Species like white-bellied heron, which has a very restricted distribution in the northeast, which is a critically endangered bird. There are species like white-winged wood duck, there are species like saras cranes, black-neck cranes, Indian skimmers, river terns, oriental dotted, painted storks, the great red ribbon storks. And these are some of the fantastic significant birds which are also threatened with extinction. So what is so significant and important about these water birds? If you look at the World Conservation Union, they have a lot of species specialist groups. In fact, there are about 130 species specialist groups, task force, red list authorities, you know, to save and conserve all the species that are present in the world. So what is very interesting to know is about 16 of these 130 specialist groups are dedicated to birds. And what is furthermore interesting is out of the 16 which are dedicated to birds, there are about 11 of these specialist groups are dedicated only to water birds. So this in itself is exemplary and signifies the importance of these water birds. So the World Conservation obviously recognizes the importance and significance of these water birds. And there is also a lot of public attention for these water birds, which is very evident in the international legislations and policies, and not only international, also the national legislations and policies and conventions. Conventions like international conventions like the Ramsar Convention, the Convention of Biological Diversity, the CITES, the important bird areas, those are all some of the best examples of how there is a large support for conserving these water birds. And what are the challenges for these water birds? There are numerous challenges. Challenges like land use change, climate change, sea level rises resulting due to climate change. There is wetland loss, wetland degradation, pollution, lack of flow, infrastructure developments like hydropower developments, poisoning, poaching, diseases. So there are a lot of the challenges and the threats are numerous. So what lays ahead for these water birds? Being a very optimistic person, I feel though there are the odds are large and looming, but nevertheless the water birds will continue to attract the attention of the conservation biologists, ecologists, planners and policy makers. We'll try to conserve these water birds through our joint efforts, and let us all take a vow to protect these wonderful water birds and one of the greatest natural wonders of this planet.